Welcome back to anatomy classes and we are continuing with the excretory system. So welcome to third session on excretory system. So today in third session we are going to learn about ureters. So the ureters are the muscular tubes continuation from the hilum of the kidney and runs downwards towards the urinary bladder. Ureters are thick muscular wall tubes and they convey the urine from the kidney to the urinary bladder. And these approximately the length of the ureters is around 10 inches in length, that is 25 centimeters in length. And proximal 5 inches lies in the abdomen and lower 5 inches lies in the pelvis. So we shall see the course of the ureter. The course of the ureter, it begins from the renal sinus, that is from the hilum of the kidney, where minor calluses joins to form the major calluses and major calluses joins to form the renal pelvis. So the renal pelvis, it is initially a dilated funnel like structure, and when it comes near to the lower pole of the kidney, it starts getting constricted and it gets narrowed down, and further it continues as ureter proper and in the posterior abdominal wall. So it lies retroperitoneally, closely related to posterior abdominal wall. And we can see here it crosses the tip. The transverse process of the lumbar vertebra, tips of the transverse process of the lumbar vertebra. And as it reaches near the pelvic brim, it crosses the bifurcation of common iliac artery. Common iliac artery divides to form external iliac, internal iliac. Common iliac are the branches, right and left common iliacs are present. They are the terminal branches of abdominal aorta. So at the site of common iliac will divide, the point where it divides, there the ureter crosses and enters into the pelvis. And once it enters into the pelvis, it runs, first it lies medial to the, over the sacroiliac joint. Then it lies along the greater sciatic notch. And after running along the greater sciatic notch, it runs over the ischial spine. So till the ischial spine, here first we can see it runs along the transverse process. Transverse process towards the medial side posteriorly, and when it enters the pelvic brim, it starts running posteriorly and little laterally along the lateral pelvic wall, related along the lateral pelvic wall. After crossing the ischial spine, then it turns to medially. So here we can see this is the ureter. So it runs posteriorly in the pelvis, and at the ischial spine it turns to the medially. So posteriorly, laterally, here downwards and medially. After crossing medially, it ductus deferens, it crosses in males, and finally it terminates in the urinary bladder. So ureteric constrictions, there are 5 ureteric constrictions. It is very important to know the sites of ureteric constrictions, because these constrictions are the potential sites for the obstruction of calculus, that is ureteric stones or renal stones. So there, the beginning with the first ureteric constriction, it is present at the pelvi-ureteric junction, that is the junction between the renal pelvis and ureter proper. It is present at the level of lower pole of kidney, that is at the level of L3, lumbar third vertebra. Second constriction, it is present at the level of pelvic brim. So in the near the pelvic brim, we know the common iliac artery divides into external iliac and internal iliac. So just in front of the bifurcation of common iliac artery, the second constriction is present. Third constriction, it is the site where the ductus deferens crosses. In males, the ductus deferens, and in females, broad ligament of uterus crosses the ureter. So the site where the ductus deferens in males and broad ligament of uterus in females crosses, that is the third site of constriction. Fourth site of constriction, just within the wall of the urinary bladder. So while entering into the wall of the urinary bladder, it gets constricted. And the final constriction, that is the fifth constriction, it is present at the site of its opening. wet the site. These are the five ureteric constrictions, and we shall see associated clinical aspect of it. Here is the intravenous pyelogram. In my previous session, we have seen the normal intravenous pyelogram. Intravenous pyelogram is a contrast X-ray where the contrast is given via the intravenous route, and this pyelogram is useful to study the parenchyma of the kidneys and renal sinus and its structures like minor calyces, major calyces, and ureters, urinary bladder. And in present picture, we can see here the right kidney and the right ureter is the normal shown, whereas on the left side there is a dilatation of the ureter, that is the renal pelvis of ureter is dilated, and below the dilatation we can see the ureter is not clearly seen. This shows the presence of ureteric calculus, the presence of stones in the ureter. To know the relations of the ureter, it is best studied under three parts, that is renal pelvis, abdominal part of the ureter, and the pelvic part of the ureter. Renal pelvis is the initial part of the ureter, which is a dilated funnel-like structure which is present till the level of lower pole of kidney. Beyond the lower pole, it is considered as the abdominal part of the ureter, and beyond the pelvic brim, once it crosses the pelvic brim, crossing the common iliac bifurcation, common iliac artery gets bifurcated there. After beyond that, it is called as the pelvic part of ureter. So let's see first, beginning with the renal pelvis, that is at its origin. So at its origin, it arises in the renal sinus from the hilum of the kidney, where minor calyces joins to form major calyces joins to form the renal pelvis. And renal pelvis, here it continues down and it gets narrowed further. So at its origin, it is related to renal vessels, that is renal artery and vein. First in order, it is vein first, then artery, then renal pelvis. This is how they are arranged in the hilum of the kidney. First is the renal vein, then VAP to remember, then artery, renal artery, and renal pelvis. So after crossing the lower pole of the kidney here, so till that level, it lies medial to the kidney, along the medial border of the kidney, with close approximation with the medial of border of the kidney it lies, and posteriorly it is related to transverse process of the lumbar vertebra, and posteriorly it rests over the psoas major muscle. So posterior relations on the right and left side are almost same, but the anterior relations are different because the abdominal organs are different on the right and left side, so anterior relations differs. So beginning with its origin, so at the renal pelvis here, at its origin near the hilum, duodenum. So second part of the duodenum is related near the origin of the ureter. After then, the ureter is crossed anteriorly by the third part of the duodenum. This is the third part of the duodenum. Further down in the abdomen, anteriorly it is crossed by the three arteries. That is, first we can still see here right gonadal artery, which is the branch of abdominal aorta here. Right gonadal artery, in females it is the ovarian artery, and in males it is testicular artery. And clinically there is a mnemonic to remember, that is water lies below the bridge. That is, here the urinary tract, that is the ureter lies below the gonadal artery. That's how surgeons remember it. And then it is also crossed by the right colic artery, which supplies the ascending colon, and iliocolic are the branches of superior mesenteric artery, which are the branches from the abdominal aorta. Iliocolic artery supplies the terminal part of the ileum, cecum, and appendix. And ureter, in its lower part in the abdomen, it is crossed by the root of mesentery, which covers the ileum. So the mesentery covering the ileum, terminal part of the ileum, crosses the lower part of the ureter. So these are the anterior relations on the right side. Let's see the left side relations. Left side, after crossing the lower pole, It is related to the left gonadal artery. It is related to left gonadal arteries. In males, it is testicular. In females, it is ovarian artery. And it is crossed by the colic artery. And it is medially left gonadal vein. It is related to the left gonadal vein. And still more medially, it is related to the inferior mesenteric vein, which terminates in the splenic vein. And left gonadal vein terminates in the renal vein. So these are the medial relations, and anteriorly it is related to the gonadal, crossed by the gonadal arteries and colic arteries. And it is also crossed by the root of mesocolon, which covers the sigmoid colon. So these are the anterior relations on the left side of the ureter. Understood, posteriorly both right and left ureters are related to the transverse process of the lumbar vertebra and psoas major. Ureter in the pelvis, here in of the pelvis of a male pelvis showing the sacrum, and the joint between the sacrum and the ilium, that is called sacroiliac joint, and the notch here is the greater sciatic notch, which ends by forming a ischial spine. So let's see the ureter relations. Ureter runs in the pelvis after crossing the pelvic brim. It runs posteriorly and laterally towards the ischial spine along the greater sciatic notch and related to sacroiliac joint. After crossing the ischial spine, it turns medially and downwards towards the urinary bladder, where it opens within the urinary bladder. Posteriorly, it is related to psoas major, and it is related to external iliac vessels before entering the pelvis. Once it enters the pelvis, here we can see the internal iliac artery and internal iliac veins run life posterior to the ureter. And the internal iliac artery divides into anterior division and posterior division. So the origin of the anterior division also lies posterior to the ureter. And posteriorly, it is also related to lumbosacral trunk, which is a trunk of lumbar plexus. So these are the posterior relations. Laterally, the ureter is related, in females it is related to ovarian fossa, and we can see the vessels present along the lateral wall. The vessels are the superior vesical artery, which supplies the urinary bladder, and obturator nerve and obturator artery, along with obturator internus and inferior vesical artery. Relations in the lower part of the ureter in males and females, they are different. In males, this is a male pelvis showing the ureter. Here is the ureter. It is crossed by the vas deferens. The vas deferens, which crosses from the lateral to the medial side of the ureter, and it is also related posteriorly to the seminal vesicles. And ureter, in its lower part, it is surrounded by the veins, inferior vesical veins, which runs along with the inferior vesical arteries. So these are the relations in the male pelvis. And in female pelvis, instead of ductus deferens or vas deferens, the ureter is crossed by the broad ligament of uterus in females. And below its termination, it is related to the uterine artery, which is closely associated with the ureter and has got lot of clinical importance. Here the case is a 30-year-old lady of 37 weeks of gestation with obstetric complication was taken up for emergency cesarean section. During her surgery, suddenly her vitals became unstable. The BP became very low, that is around 80 by 50, and heart rate shown tachycardia of 130 per minute, and there was an hematuria, that is presence of RBCs in the urine, was observed in her urobag. And surgeon observed excess fluid accumulation while suturing uterus. So then the surgeon found out the reason for the condition and started repairing the structure closely related to uterine artery. What is the probable structure involved? The probable structure which is involved here is the ureter. So the ureter is the structure which is very closely related to uterine artery, and the chances of ureteric damage is very commonly associated with the hysterectomy or during C-section. Blood supply of ureters. The proximal part of the ureters are supplied by the renal arteries and gonadal arteries. The mid segment of the ureters are supplied by the lumbar arteries and peritoneal arteries. And after crossing the pelvic brim, the ureters are supplied from the direct branches of common iliac arteries and internal iliac arteries. And before its termination, it is supplied by the inferior vesical artery in males, and it is replaced by uterine arteries and vaginal arteries in females. Next, about the nerve supply, it has got the sympathetic and parasympathetic nerve supply. Sympathetic supply are derived from the thoracic segment from T10 to lumbar segment L1, T10 to L1. And parasympathetic supply are by hypogastric plexus. They are derived from the sacral segments from S2 to S4. So this is about the nerve supply of ureters. So completing with the third session of excretory system, next we shall continue with the fourth session on excretory system with the urinary bladders. I hope you all like my session. Please like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell button for further notifications. Bye.